to drop things off, yeah, out of your life, and to make a priority, make something a priority, or more of a priority, or just maybe there's just too many things, there's too many options going on right now, yeah? So you gotta make choices. You gotta make choices as to what things you gotta prioritize in your life right now that are most important for you to feel good about yourself and to feel successful, right? And it's odd. It may seem like an odd choice, you know? It may seem like the choice that you weren't expecting, but I think it's the right choice. Whatever that is for you. It's funny too, because I was planning on going to that concert all week. I was actually looking forward to that concert. It's with a really good friend of mine. Her name's Deb. Invited me out, but there was another choice to be made. And I think it's the right one. The question I have for you guys, right, just starting out, and this is, you can consider this part of the collective reading, both here on Twitch and on TikTok, is what are the choices that need to be made right now that you know are the right choice, but may feel a little uneasy or a little weird or different than what you were expecting? Because there may be a crossroads you're facing that you're not quite sure what to do with it or where to go or how to step into it or where to step, exactly. But the thing about it is you got to make that choice in order for your life to be able to progress in the right way. And you have to rely on your deeper inner intuition as well, not the head. The deeper intuition, what does your body tell you about what choices to be making right now? Who to be spending your time with, how to be spending your time exactly. And it may seem unconventional, by the way. It may seem very unconventional. A lot of you guys dealing with stalkers, huh? This is like the second or third person that has come onto the live stream. We have someone on TikTok dealing with a stalker. And we said some notes about it too. If you guys are dealing with someone who seems to be obsessively, you know, chasing you or not leaving you alone, right? We had that Mars and Venus conjunction. It was a rather aggressive conjunction. But what it did was it forced the masculine and feminine polarities together in a way that had you deal with or look at any of the fears or beliefs within yourself around the opposite polarity. This is what it did. Mars and Venus came into a conjunction. Mars and Venus came into a conjunction, which brought in the opposite or polarizing energy to you. And there's two ways it could have gone. It could have gone with a lot of harmony and a lot of excitement and a lot of passion and a lot of alignment. And that's how you know it was that you're on the right track with who and what you're attracting into your life and everything, the way it's going, the choices you're making, your inner reality, your inner truth. Or there could have been some friction and a lot of resistance and a lot of force, right, coming into the picture. And a lot of a need to block or to restrain or to resist, right? But I want you to look inside of yourself and see what is it that you have been resisting or trying to block or restrain within yourself that is then attracting, right, that reality to you. You guys see that? This is channeled, by the way. So those of you guys who are dealing with stalkers or people who are aggressive in your life, why is it showing up? Why is it showing up? Let's talk about it. Let's talk about it seriously. Okay. If we take the viewpoint, okay, with all love here, okay, if we take the viewpoint of we are responsible for what we attract to us in some way, shape, or form, and that we have more control over how and what our external reality is than we think or would ever have ever been taught to believe, and we know and take the viewpoint that something within our own internal truth or mechanisms inside or our belief systems inside that's present within us is the thing that is causing those external factors to be attracted to you, to reflect back to you what is present inside. And if you have been forced to engage with resistance, restraining, or blocking someone from the outside. What is that thing that you have been resisting, blocking, or restraining within your own internal reality? That is the question I would ask. And I promise you, the moment that you see what that thing is, probably related to romance, could be romance, could be sex, could be an affair. Okay, some type of engagement romantically with the opposite polarity. Those are the things to look at. Because Mars and Venus coming together, I mean, it's going to bring things together, right? But astrologically, there's higher energies that are potentiated when planets come together, and there's lower energies that are potentiated. But the way in which we dictate whether we get to experience the higher energies of planets coming together or lower energies is by the health of our internal reality, our internal state. So some of you this most recent week when this conjunction happened brought in someone or attracted someone or maybe even multiple people who had amazing energy without even having to do anything. Maybe you attracted someone to your life that is like incredibly amazing on your level, aligned with you, sexy as hell, romantically appealing, everything seems really good, and that energy is helping you to be more of yourself. That's the other possibility. Okay? So, Cloud and Bunny on TikTok is asking, how do you get rid of it? How do you get rid of it? It's very, very simple, okay? So for anyone who is struggling with this, okay? Anyone who's going through this, all you have to do is feel the same energy. I want you to imagine that this person in this situation, this relentless, right? If someone's provoking you in some way, I want you to imagine that they are your greatest teacher. This might sound crazy to some of you guys, okay? I want you to imagine that they're your greatest teacher and they're your greatest mirror and reflection of the internal reality and state with which you hold inside of yourself. Otherwise, they would not come into your reality externally if there was not something inside of you that needed to be shown. Does this make sense so far to you guys? Hello, Angel Summer. Pinzi Zucchini Emma said, oh God, LOL, it's lack of boundaries. Could be lack of boundaries as well, and possibly lack of boundaries within yourself or to yourself as well, okay? Or lack of boundaries generally. But once you feel into, right, the energy within which they are coming at you or within which they are appearing to you, you feel into what that causes within you, whether it's fear, whether it's frustration, whether it's anger, whatever it is, then you view that as a teacher and you go fully into that feeling as deeply as you can possibly go, and you literally ask that feeling. Now, this is a step-by-step instruction. I've been doing this for years. It will transform your life if you can do this. Okay? And you say, feeling, what are you here for? Feeling, anger, sadness, despair. Right? What are you trying to show me? Fear, pure fear, says Cloud and Bunny. Fear, what are you trying to show me? Where does this fear arise? What trauma happened in my life? When I was a kid or when I was younger, at some part of my life, doesn't have to be when you're a kid, that felt the exact same as this particular emotion that this situation or person is bringing up now. Does that make sense? And then, if you follow that emotion, you will find the origin of the event that caused the initial fear. Do you guys see that? So it's all, everything that is happening in our lives right now, by the way, everything that's happening in our lives right now is simply a reflection of the trauma, if it's negative, right? If it feels negative, of the trauma that we still hold so we can become aware of it. That's it. So if we can undo and release the trauma inside, it goes away. So Cloud and Bunny, hear me now. If you want it to stop, you have to go into the fear. That's it. It's very simple. You have to go into the fear and you have to literally face the fear inside of yourself, not externally. Don't even worry about the person. Just keep him at bay, or him or her, whoever it is, and go inside of yourself. Ask the fear, deal with the fear, face the fear. Release the fear by dealing with it, by being present with it, by understanding its origin. If you need to forgive something or release something, you can do that too by practicing the Ho'oponopono prayer. Okay? And then I promise this person or whatever situation is causing this will just completely dissolve. It's like, it'll be like they never even existed. I promise you. And then guess what happens? Okay? Then, because you've released the trauma inside of your body, then you get to attract the higher energies of the potentialities that these planetary alignments bring. Which would mean if Mars and Venus come in conjunct, now you get to attract in what you actually desire to have. You guys see? It's like magic. It's like magic. Hello. First time. Good to have you here. Let me know if you guys have questions around this, right? This is the methodology I've been working with for many, many years, and it is 100% transformed everything about my life. Once you understand this one secret piece of knowledge, that's not so secret anymore, by the way, even astrophysicists and scientists are, there's now real life theories that are speculating and theorizing that the entire universe and everything that has manifested externally is the exact same as our internal reality. Like everything from the atoms and the molecules and the cells and the neutrons and the protons and the opposite polarity, like it's all replicated externally as it is internally on a metaphysical level. So it's the same thing emotionally. Okay. And Michelle says, you must be feeling yourself. You're glowing. I'm feeling the shit out of myself. Could you tell? I'm feeling the shit out of myself. Yeah. 100%. Because this knowledge needs to get out, you know? If you guys are suffering in some way, right? If you guys are suffering or anything like that, like, this is it. This is the stuff to do. Because there's a whole lot of fun to be had right now. There's like, oh my gosh. And then you just got to be patient, by the way. So once if you're doing this type of work on a consistent basis, then you just got to be patient for what you really want to come in. Because it's coming. It's coming. You just got to wait for the astrological alignments to happen. That's it. That's the secret. It's like the way astrology works is for every single alignment, right? You imagine on an everyday basis, you are practicing doing the inner reality shifts, the inner work, the inner emotional well-being work on a daily basis, and doing your physical work out in the world, right? And so long as you're keeping an emotionally clean, a pristinely clean emotional and spiritual template, for the most part, right? You don't have to be perfect with this. If you continue to do that work on a daily basis, spiritually and emotionally, most importantly, and mentally, then when amazing conjunctions come together, like Mars and Venus, then you get the most amazing opportunities to come your way. You get a reward, right? But you just have to wait for that to happen. Okay. All right, sorry, I had to go on that ramble, guys. What's going on, everyone? Thank you so much for watching that live collective reading or the highlight from it from my recent...